Morning. Had a bad day yesterday. I did two demonstrations and I zoomed in the camera on these photographs. That's a picture I took at Seven Islands, Mitcham Common, yesterday. That's my bike there. And that's one of the pictures I took. Straighten up a bit. It's very beautiful. It's a suburban parkland surrounded by industrial estates and housing and all sorts, but a lovely place to go. We take it for granted. I never went there as a lad. My friends did. They go fishing all around here, but I never knew it until before Christmas, and I only did 20 minutes bike ride away. So I thought I'd do it in acrylic because I had all my paints on this stay wet palette. So I'm going to take this off now and I'm going to pin it or clip it up on the top when I find my wretched clip. Can't find anything. I'm a lost cause, I'm afraid. I work in an absolute mess. Not as bad as Francis Bacon, was it? So I'm going to zoom out, which is I singly forgot to do yesterday, and I did two demonstrations of this, or based on it. I don't do any exact portraits, but in both occasions, I forgot to zoom out after showing the photograph. So I'm going to do it again. That's one of the demos that I did of it, and stupidly, again, I painted on the other side, so I've got two perfectly good pictures here on the same sheet of paper. This is the Fabriano watercolour paper, which went wrong with the watercolours, and I've just hunted through the demos, the early demos that I did early last year for you on YouTube, and turn it over to the blank side of it. So I've got a pile of YouTube demonstrations over 12 inches high now. There would have been a lot more, but some are in a gallery and I've sold a few here and there, not for great sums of money. I tried the link to eBay with auctions above 99p to start with. And one of my friends phoned up to say that his son-in-law had phoned him to say, I've just got one of Dave's paintings off of eBay for 99p. Well, my paintings are worth a lot more than that. And since I do this for nothing, it's nice to be able to sell them for reasonable prices. So I've stopped doing that. Right, the palette I'm using, so a bit about acrylic. It's non-toxic. Well, I wouldn't eat it, but the solvents you use are non-toxic, mostly water. But you can use PVA glue diluted. You don't have to buy expensive extenders to keep the stuff from drying out too quickly or glazing. Just use PVA glue. It's cheap and it works. This is all PVA glue with colour, albeit so very refined. So I've got on here a load of white. You need a lot of white, and I buy that in, well, I haven't bought any for several years. I'm still using up what I bought before I did the YouTube stuff. Light red, I've got this vermilion here that I don't use a lot of. I could use alizarin. I've got ultramarine, burnt sienna, black if I use it, some viridian, and yellow ochre. I use yellow ochre and lemon yellow, or cadmium yellow, light. Medium. I use raw sienna with watercolour because it's transparent, but yellow ochre for the oil or acrylic paintings. It's got great covering ability. Now, I'm not going to do any drawing on this. I'm going to go straight in with, and I'm not going to use any medium. I'm going to mix up some blue sky because it was a lovely day yesterday. It's not a lovely day today. And get some nice bluey colour. That's probably a bit grey, but the idea is just to cover the paper at the stage, and we can refine it later as we go. These take a lot longer to do than watercolours. But the lovely thing to do, this palette, it with a lid, they come in various sizes. This is the largest one they do. This is Masterson. It's made for Chroma Colour, which is an American company. They make some very, very good acrylic inks. And I'll sit that down there. And there's a warehouse near here, near me, which is open to the public, and I occasionally go there. If I need some acrylics, I'll go in and buy some. Right, whatever you do, if you use this, don't forget to keep your brushes nice and moist, because if it dries on your brushes, you can say goodbye to them. I'm going to use a bit of light red. I'll blend all this. This is a nice light red. It's very good used with white. It goes sort of pinky and warm colour for a nice little low horizon. Just a bit of blending. I'm having to hold the brush like that because my fingers cramp. A new brush here. These are just cheap Chinese bristle brushes, and they lose a ferocious amount of hair for a while, but they're very good for, look at that. I should have used a more warm brush, because this will all stick into the paint. I'll find another brush, hold on. I'll use this one here. In a rage, I threw my brushes at the wall yesterday, because I'm so annoyed at wasting all my time to upload the things, or to record the things, to find that I hadn't zoomed out. It's just a waste of time. But anyway, that's painting for you. Let's keep this. Right, let's get that in there. Low horizon. This is a lovely surface to paint on. Right, I'll go back to my blue. The plenty of rag. Is that the one? Right. To a certain extent, if the acrylic dries, you can soften it with methylated spirits. I think in America it's called denatured alcohol. Oh, right, let's just get in here with yourself blending the colours a little bit. Trying to replicate the nice blue sky just coming down into the lighter area. Some lighter light red now. Just a little bit of red in it. Not a lot, but also I want it quite light to blend into . Do for a minute. I'm going to put in some sky colour now in here, just where the water is going to be approximately. So nice blue. This is a very small lake, or a large pond with some islands, small island, very small, lovely nature reserve type of place. Right, just a basic colour in there. Okay, now with a smaller brush, I'm going to put in a, I don't know, I need to get that coming down a little bit more there. Let's find the right brush. No, it doesn't really matter. That's still a bit too light, too red. I'm going to go over that again, but I just want to bring that down a bit. I want to cover all the paper. But you can alter very quickly and very subtly with acrylic. Well, it can with oil, but this dries so quickly that by the time you've sort of gone from one side to the other, it's almost dry. But if it's not dry, you will lift the paint underneath, like there. So I just want that to all nice gently to blend up there. Going back in with some blue now. And then I will put in some light clouds, just floating across the sky, but it went fairly dark here because it's overhead. Just blending into all that underneath. Right, now sky colour. I've also got some tea going cold. So it's this ready, well, the light red with a little bit of white. Oh, just floating across over the top here. Just floating across the sky there. Now, I've got a problem there, I've done them all the same. So I'll modify those. So let's get rid of that one. All very, very subtle now. So that's not covering that bit there, that's because that's still a little bit damp. I'll just overload the brush with that. I took the photograph about 10:30 yesterday morning. All very indistinct here. Okay, that'll do. Right, with my little brush, I'm going to go into the background with some blue, bit of that vermilion in there, bit of white, and we'll. This is the background over which I'm going to superimpose some darker, lighter stuff. Whatever you put on, you can cover up. Now, I want this quite dark behind here, because there's some very light twiggy stuff, silver birches, or spindly silver birches, lots of pond type of foliage. Now over that, there's, now if I could put it down a bit light there, just because I want to put in some nearer trees. Now this is going to make it look really distant, but it isn't. It's only a couple of hundred yards, but we're going to create an illusion of depth on this. Try to vary the shapes here. Most of this is going to be covered up, but I just want some of it to show through to give the distant effect. So I'm using just a grey blue. So I've mixed it with the vermilion. Right, and we'll go. There's a big island here, or big is a relative term because there's nothing big here. It's just a suburban landscape in the park. Let's get that. Well, this is a dark bit because I want that to be the background for the lighter that I show what I mean. Here, we've got all this leafless, because it's spring, all round here. It's just all feathered in, and it's not grass or anything, it's just trees. There's a little bit of green showing up here and there. So let's just get that in there. You can feather it a little bit just to soften. Alright, that's nice and soft. Right, now, with a bit of burnt sienna now, with the blue, makes a nice warm dark. I'm going to put in some trees in the background here, coming right up from. Get a nice shape going. It's just touching. I'm not copying slavishly, but I will never do. I'm just making a piece of art. It's got trees and water and skies, the usual. Right, that's a show. That's more or less the shape that's there. And then we've got, in here we've got a silver birch, the tip of one. It's about the same sort of height as those other trees, so I'm just going to put in the tip twigs, because they're very spindly trees, they're lovely trees. So just do something like that. That'll do. That's probably overdone. And then we've got more trees in here. Then we've got some more here. So there's some of that blue is now is being covered up, but it's not all being covered up. It's that's where the dark has got to go. So I'm going to mix that with a bit darker there. Because those trees on the islands are going to come up into that. But it's all about painting light to dark. You'll see what I mean in a minute when I get around to doing it. Right, now we've got the greens. Just some ready mixed greens on the palette. Palette green, this is. It's just not really green, is it? But I'll just put it in just to show that there is some. I will go over this with a bit more blue. Mix a bit of light with the green just to tone it down a bit. It's the only green I use really in a regular basis if I'm using oil or acrylic, and that's viridian, but I never use it on its own. It's always a colour to use as a modifier. That's the bank over there. Right. Let's go back with this colour here. Let's just slip all some of these in. When I put in the some trunks and stuff, it'll make sense. Right, so let's go in with the warmer colours here. Right, get some blue back in there over this, because there's not a lot of light. Well, there is some light, but not a lot. What that? I'm missing a burnt sienna with ultramarine, a bit of white, just to kill some of that green a little bit. I can always put lights back into here. Sending it back a little bit. I'll let that dry off a little bit there. I'll just start to put in some of the island. Yeah, it's coming down. Well, I've got to put the bank in first, and then it's got some nice lights going in the light bank. So I'll use blue and burnt sienna. Try and get the bank a bit straight. It's going across there, and we've got this, the other islands coming, or this one coming down here. And there is a bit of a debris patch here, which is very, it's got a lot of colour in it, so I'm going to put that in. Then we've got the other island, which is coming across here, with nice bits of dark in it. Put in the shadow with the reflections as we go. We'll start with reflections anyway. That's going to be dark there. Okay. Put in some darks here. The shadow underneath the foliage. But I want this fairly dark in places because I'm going to superimpose the silver birches. Let's put some more colour in there. This is where the fun starts. Get the and some green in there, a bit of white. Lots of colour, all very subtly put in. Just using the edge of the brush to just to use the thin hairs to create an impression of a lot going on when there's not really. Right, now let's go in with this shimmer of twigs, fine twigs, and I'm going to use burnt sienna and a lot of white, maybe a bit of yellow ochre, but that's all the way up here. And you should see why. I might have to even put darker behind here. And there's someone on the far bank as well. There's another little sort of island in there. Just scumbling or dragging over. Here. See, you can dry brush it because it's dry so quick. You can dry brush over the top of it. You're building up a paint layer that needs to be darker in there for the shadow. So, if I put that in, it's reflecting this here. So we'll just gently put that in, and that will give a background for showing up these light bits here. It's a tree button that. Tree there, that silver birch there, that's got to go in. So let's just put these in. Right, let's go with the darker bits behind here. Blue and sienna on the blue side. Well, that's a bit too much. We'll do the same on the other side, on this bit here. So now you can see why we're doing what we're doing. Just banging the brush. Quite a bit of burnt sienna in there. And the burnt sienna with a bit of white goes like the light really goes a little bit pinky, which is lovely, the lovely one. And they're nice and light on the top there, but not with just pure white paint. Just with a lot of tint to it. It's because it's all catching the light, all hairy, lovely. I'll just put that reflecting in here. In there. Right, okay. Now we're getting with some darks now in there. So blue and brown, or shimmer. The shadow areas in here. That needs to be stippled out there. That's a bit too much white showing through from the shape, from the surface of the paper. Right, let's bend that a bit more. Oh, this hair's just falling out of this. Right, some dark, there's some darks in there now. That one's got to be stuck back. I should say that they are cheap. I'm just going to add a bit more ultramarine. It's getting older stuff now. I hope it is. But eventually it dries in the tube. But I want to get these nice, Now I'm going to get some more colours in here, a bit of green. I'll mix the greens with a bit of the viridian, a bit of yellow ochre, a bit of white. Just to give a hint of there being some spring growth in there. Same in here. I can just gently scoop that over there. let's put in some lights on the distant shore now. Nice. You can use, if this was flat, I'd use a knife, edge of a, soften it, edge of a painting knife. Because that brush is spitting across. I could, if I'm very careful, use this inch brush, but you have to make sure you clean it out very fastidiously afterwards, otherwise you'll have lost your expensive brush. Right, bit of bank going back in here. These do take time, it's going to take hours to upload it to YouTube, well, for several hours anyway. But you can always fast forward. I'm sure you do, because I know I do. But you might not want to fast forward, you might want to just put your feet up with a cup of tea or something stronger and just enjoy. Just a nice light, a bit of yellow in the background there now. Just to show a bit of light through there. And then just a bit of shadow back in the base of all this here. Wrong brush, but I really want that line across there. Let go for a minute. Clean my brush. Right, I'm going to do a bit of work on there now. Just there's a little bit of black in that mix, so I'm on the shortcut. I'm taking too long now. So I just want to put this. Now I've got a bank around there. Just. Where you put on the top? Drag down below, and it'll give that impression of there being a. It'll make the water look wet. Now, there's lots of bits of greeny, whitey, ochrey stuff in here. Lots of little white bits and, well, reflecting this. The light off them, shining off the wet bits of twiggy leaves and stuff. Right, that's a bit of darker stuff in there now. I'll put the bank in. I know, I need to put in the silver birches in that, so I'm going to use this flat brush because the hairs will stay together, but just a little bit of colour in the white. Oh, we'll just see what happens here. Don't forget to make sure the paint doesn't dry on the brush while you're not looking at it. I'll put some over here. I'll modify these with some darks because you always get lovely dark bits on silver birches where the bark's peeling. Darker colour. Clean the brush. We've got one here. It's got a show. Otherwise, there's some point in putting it in. Now, I'm sorry if I'm good masking, but we've got all these in there, so more or less where they are. Just showing the reflections, more or less where they are. put a bit of dark underneath. That. Just a tiny bit of stronger white here and there. Just so it shows. Right, I'm using an old rigger now. Just a I don't think they've come out very well with that brush. Right, and now we'll just mess it up a little bit. Now, let's see if we can, with a rigger, just start a bit of calligraphy in the distance here. We're going back to watercolours soon, don't worry. That's not very good. I'll let that dry out. That's gone a bit thick there. Let's just run that out. Right, now I'm going to really try to get some fine lines in here now. I can't put trunks in dark against a dark background, so I'll do it with the yellow ochre and a bit of sienna. Sort of a grey. There are no big trees here. It's quite an exposed spot. Although there's been quite a bit of landfill going on in this area. Got a junk it somewhere, but they've put hills in what was a flat landscape, which was lovely. There's a golf course, Mitcham golf course nearby. That's still nice and flat. Well, flattish. Upon what you'd have in bunkers and things. But it was a lovely, lovely area. There's a nice, light, sandy, sort of whitish colour there. So I wouldn't put that in because that is catching the light. Sort of rough that up a bit there, that's just a bit too even. I'll have to put in some light. I'll use a half inch flat. I need to get my blue back there now. Get some of that sky colour in there. Let's get some blue in there. I need to get some more white, so hold on. We're nearly done. Well, we're getting there anyway. That's the size of the tube, the pot I buy, 75 millilitres. It's got a bit mucky there, so I've changed that. Let's get some blue mixed up here. Just glaze over that a little bit. Sending that back a little bit. Where's my little bit? lighten up some of that. Get that light back here. Reflecting what's behind me, I'll lower down. I'm going to put in some more of these trees now, just to I wouldn't normally paint so quick, well, relatively quickly, if I was doing this just for myself, but I've got to try to do it as fast as I can because of all the technology of the upload. All right, let's just get some of this heavier stuff in here. I don't want to get any thick lines in this. Shouldn't have done that. Let's go back some white there. My little brush here. I'm going to take, lighten that up a little bit. I think it just needs a little bit of that tender care in there. I went a bit over the top with that. So I'm up and just block it out a little bit. So I'm sending this back into the distance again now. It's done its job. I'll put that back there. I'll let it dry off a little bit. I've lost my rigger. I still want to get some little bits of light on there. Thank you. Just try and stroke in some lights and now I've got to put some of, oh that's that hasn't dried off yet. I'll give that a bit of a help. Right, clean that brush again. I just put some little tiny bits of twig for this silver birch. That's gone a bit nasty there. Back to the rigger. Right, well I can't do very much more to that, I don't think. I'm going to sign it, put it in a mount, and we'll have a look to see what we've done. I'll put a couple of birds in. That has not come out quite as well as I'd hoped, but anyway, I'll get my mount. There's the picture, and that's what I've done with it. Mount coming up. Okay, well, that's not too bad. That's probably just a little bit heavy in there, but I don't see what I can do to alter that. That's it. No, I'll just put a little bit of light back, a bit of green or something back in there. Right, that. Right, there we are. I'll zoom into that and show you what we've done. Just move the camera around a little bit so it will go straight. Probably I've got that a bit too even there. So I'll just gently take that, just alter that shape there. Better shape. Right, okay. Well, it's done. So, Seven Islands, Mitcham Common. Zoom out again. By me. Hope you enjoyed that. Thanks for having the patience to sit through it, if you have. Goodbye.